Hello friends, I'm Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see Scilab Scalars and Vectors Part 2. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to perform mathematical functions used in Scilab. Content: relational operations on vectors, logical operations on vectors, built-in logical function, elementary mathematical functions, we'll see trigonometric functions, inverse trigonometric function, hyperbolic function. Relation operations on vectors. Scilab uses 6 relation operators for mathematical comparisons of vectors. Relation operations results in a vector of a same size with the answer T when the relation is true and F when relation is false. First operation among 6. First is less than. The relation operator used as less than sign as shown here, less than. Suppose if there are 2 vectors, X row vector and Y as a row vector, the relation between X and Y, that is less than, X is less than Y, it is denoted as X less than Y, then the output will be F T F F, where F is for false and T is for true. We'll have a quick where X is equal to, I'll take a row 2, 4, 6, 8, I'll press enter, this is row vector. Y as in 2, 4, 2, 5, 7, 9, like this. Then I use enter. Then X is less than Y, very simple. So you get F T T. You can see the first element 2, here also 2, it is equal, it is not less than, it is false. Then all others are here 5, X is less, that is 4 is less than 5, 6 is less than 7 and 8 is less than 9, obviously all will be true. So we can use in the above example, like I mean in this example, that the second number 3 is less than 4, so 3 is less than 4, it shows true, then all other cases it shows false. Less than or equal to operator, in the same way we can use same vectors, you can use the operator less than or equal to sign, it shows the output, T is true, again F is false. In the same way we can use greater than relation operator, the sign is greater sign, X and Y are defined, then X is greater than Y, you get the output. And in the same way, greater than or equal to, so just we are using greater than symbol first, then equal to symbol here. So X and Y are defined variables, then if you want to check the relation between 2 vectors, X is greater than Y, you'll get the output again. So these are very simple calculations you can try on your Scilab console window. So here the important thing is whenever you want to find equal to, the operator is used as equal to 2 times. So you need to remember whenever you want to check the relation between 2 operators, we use equal to as equal to and equal to for 2 times. So here you can see the first element 2 is equal, that's why it is showing true. Rest all is a false. Next, not equal to, so this negation and equal to sign is for not equal to. Here X and Y, X we are using not equal to operator, then Y, here first one shows false, then all 3 shows true, because 2 is equal to 2, the output will be opposite, that is false. Rest all as true. Then we'll see logical operations on vector. Logical operator, we use the AND operator here. You need to remember this sign AND. The operation results in a vector of same size with the answer T when both the expressions are true and F when it is false. So there are 2 vectors again, X and Y. So here I have taken a command like X is greater than Y and X is greater than 2, then show the output. So it will show FFT, that is X. X is greater than Y. That is false actually. In the first case itself, it is false. So it goes to false. Second case is 3 is greater than 4. This is also not possible. So it shows F. Second case, 7 is greater than 5. So this is true. And it checks, that is 7 is greater than 2. That's why it shows true. In the same way, we can perform AND operator. And this is the same statement I have explained. Then logical OR operator. For OR operator, we are using this dash sign. So here X and Y are given. So we are using X, this dash, and Y. So the output will be FTTT. In the same way, logical complement sign is shown here in the figure. So X and Y, so that will be opposite to the OR. If you want to show the output opposite, you can use this sign. So these are three logical operator signs: AND, OR, and complement. Built-in logical function. So built-in logical function is empty. This function returns a true value for an empty matrix. Suppose I have given a vector X is equal to 0, 3, 7, 8. And if you want to check whether there is an element inside this vector, just type is empty of X. You find it is false because there are few elements inside this vector. So is empty is to check whether the vector is empty or not. Very simple. Next function is to find. So in a vector, if you want to find any value, suppose X is a vector, here we need to find X greater than 5 is real. It checks whether the given function is real or not. If it is real, the output will be true, that is T. I'll show you the quick calculations. I'll clear this window first. CLC, enter. I'll define a vector A as 0, 1, 2, 3, bracket complete, enter, and I'll check is empty is empty A. So it should show false, that there is some elements in this. And find A greater than 1, enter. So it will show greater than 1. The values are 2 and 3 and 4. Okay. So it shows the position, not the values. So third position is greater than 1 and fourth position is greater than 1. So in the same way here also, here greater than 5, it shows the position. So 3 means that is the third position, seventh element, and fourth position, that is number 8. So is real is used. Then is global is also used. If the function returns a true value, then variable declared is global. Okay. Then elementary mathematical functions are used. For example, clean, the function rounds all small values down to 0. Suppose there are very small values like 0.000, that will be equal to 0 when we use the function clean. For example, let us take a matrix and we do a calculation like A into A matrix, or we take a new matrix B, that is A into inverse of A. That should be a identity matrix, but in Scilab we'll get the value like this. That is 1, the diagonal element is 1, 1, 1, and other all elements should be 0, but Scilab shows -3.053 10 - 16. It means it is 10^-16. This is -17. So in such cases, we can use a clean function. If you use clean matrix B, the all the elements which is smaller, it becomes 0. So clean is used to bring the low value to 0. Next, seal. This function rounds a floating point number to the next higher integer. For example, we are using seal for 1.2 space 1.5 space 1.9 minus 1.2. Here it will seal. Seal means it is above. So it will show the value which is next value which is in whole number, like 2, 2, 2, and it is minus, so it will show the below value, that is minus 2. So seal is the pointing showing the higher integer. If we use floor, it shows the lower integer. Same value, it will show 1, 1, 1 and minus 2. You can try this, it is fun when we use these examples, like it shows floor value and seal value. We have another example like round. This is usually rounds of the nearest integer in a usual way. For example, here it shows 1. The values which are above 0.5, then it shows the next higher integer, which is below 5, it shows the lowest integer. We use fix also. So fix, this function arounds floating point number towards 0. So that floating number becomes 0, then it shows the only first number, that is 1.2 is directly fixed to 1 and 1.9 is also fixed to 1. So think, list down few trigonometric functions used in Scilab. Pause the video for a few seconds and think. So we can go trigonometric functions, we can do a basic functions like sine, cos, tan that supports the Scilab. It uses the right angle triangle formula. For example, sine 45, just you need to give a function sine and the angle, you get the answer. In the same way, cos angle, and for tan or tangent we use a trigonometric function tan. These are the references I have used. Thank you.